Yeah, your boy Super Squirrel. Yeah, we on the Hooligan Express. My man Fat Ant ride a shotgun with me. Rest in peace, Burley. Rest in peace, Pookie Lee. AT Wizzle, somebody roll up something while we out here trying to figure it out.
You already know who the fuck this is. I'm in a fucking building, nigga.
Sent in pictures of something she found in the desert this weekend. We knew we had to look into this. Tiny purple spheres seem to appear out of nowhere.
So, oh, it was crazy, dude. Totally out of the blue. I mean, I was just sitting there and I was like, oh.
And our viewer wanted some answers.
Not in your sides, Liz Kotelik saw these strange jelly-like objects, and she joins us here in the studio to tell us what these objects just might be.
Guy, this is definitely something that I have never seen before. There were thousands of these weird little spheres piled in the middle of the desert, and although I'd like to believe that they were maybe something out of this world, we spoke to one source today who may have another explanation.
Tell me what happened.
Well, I was just driving down Northern Avenue, getting ready to pull into Albertsons, and all of a sudden, I was just minding my own business. Bam!
It was a normal Sunday in Vail for Geraldine Vargas. Normal until she and her husband stumbled upon something kind of weird.
We were taking photos around the area and we just, I mean, how could you miss this? It was just like glittering in the sun.
Thousands of these tiny purple-hued spheres piled in the middle of nowhere.
It's just one of those things that you've never seen before.
They were watery. Some were translucent, and the pile was completely isolated. Geraldine was amazed, and she wanted answers.
We did email a friend of ours, who's a zoologist, but she didn't know. I mean, she didn't seem to recognize what it was.
So she sent K-Gun 9 these pictures, hoping we could figure it out. So we checked out the mysterious spheres for ourselves today, and they were still there. They're like gooey marbles that ooze out a water substance when we swish them. They roll, they shine, and they're just out of this world.
We're dying to know what it is.
And so are we. We spoke to Darlene Barreau, the director of marketing at Tucson Botanical Gardens, whose husband is a botanist. He said if these are something naturally occurring, they could be slime mold or jelly fungus. But no one is positive what these spheres are. And for now, all we can say for certain is that they're definitely out of the ordinary.
Now we've reached out to other sources in the biology field to try to figure out exactly what these spheres could be. So far, the only practical explanation we have is that it could be some sort of fungal growth. I'm going to try to do this quickly. You heard the story earlier today, didn't you? My mother found something similar to this. And it turned out that they were these air freshener beads that you can buy at the store, and they had fallen out of a bag that she had, and it rained, and the rain soaked up those air freshener beads. She had the Department of Game and Fish at her house. They were taking samples, and
because they're scary looking,
they're very strange looking.
Yeah, because they're scary looking.
They're very strange looking.
Yeah, because they're scary looking.
They're very strange looking.
Yeah, because they're scary looking.
They're very strange looking. Because she thought that she had some kind of strange new species.
There were thousands of these.
Some kind of strange new species growing in her house.
That's what this is?
That's my guess. That's just a guess, but that's only based on a kind of ironic experience that we also had.
So. Right, well, Darlene told us that this kind of a fungus isn't really something that's normal in this type of climate, so yeah. Maybe it's the Febreze.
You gotta get back to us on this. You gotta let us know when we find out.
I will keep you updated.
Right, absolutely. Thank you. Okay.
Funerals are expected to begin on Monday for the 233 people who died in a nightclub fire in Santa Maria, Brazil. Families of the victims came to the city of Santa Maria and identified victims' bodies in a gym that's now serving as a morgue. Police suspect the fire at the Kiss nightclub began when a band set off pyrotechnics or fireworks during its performance early Sunday morning. When the foam sound insulation on the ceiling caught fire, it filled the club with toxic smoke, choking the hundreds of people still inside. Smoke inhalation is blamed for most of the deaths.
because a nigga got dough. Extraordinary swag in the mouth full of gold. O's at my shows, they be stripping off their clothes. And if all the girls write a nigga name on their toe. Right. Niggas talk shit till they get locked jaw.
During a performance early Sunday morning, when the foam sound insulation on the ceiling caught fire.
I saw the shooting. You know, it was saying that it was a shooting on the news. So they were brought here. It first said that it was at my oldest daughter's school, which was at Carver. And then when they started showing it on the news saying it was Price, and I saw, like, you know, a white blanket on the ground, the first thing I could think of was...
There were thousands of these. They were watery.
The first thing I thought of was that it could be my child, you know, laying there on the ground. So that would let me here.
Who's here?
My son, Michael Martin.
Okay. And he hasn't come out yet?
No, he has not come out yet. I have not heard from him. Even when I called to the school line was saying that this number is not a working number. So I have not heard anything. I mean, the assistant principal came out and he talked to, you know, all the parents saying that all the kids were fine, but that still did not make me feel any better because I did not see my son.
What's going through your head right now with all the activities lately with violence at schools and where young people are? What's going through your head right now?
I mean, all type of stuff is going through my head. I mean, I'm thinking that, you know, it's my son that was laying down on that ground or my niece that was laying down on that ground. You know, it was very frightening.
How good is it back to have them back in your arms right now?
It's the best feeling in the world. It's like giving birth.
Some kind of strange new species.
It's like giving birth all over again.
What was going through your mind when you saw him and when you got to put your arms back around him?
Joy. True joy.
Major achievement for Iran's aerospace research. The country has successfully sent a capsule containing a monkey into space.
Yep, you heard him. Iran have successfully sent a monkey into space. It's not been independently verified, but the state news agency is calling it an advance in Iran's missile and space program. The live monkey was sent 75 miles into the air on board the Kavashkar rocket, with reports claiming the shipment returned intact.
I said it must be, that's a nigga got you. Extraordinary swag in the mouth full of gold. O's at my shows, they be stripping off their clothes. And if all the girls write a nigga name on their toe. Right. Niggas talk shit till they get locked jaw. Chrome till you don't, till you get glocked jaw. Party like a cowboy or a rock star. Ain't got to play the best out of shit by far.
Coupled with the relief of liberation were palpable. Scrubbing out the graffiti of oppressive orders and somewhat unsuccessfully trying to set fire to the purple jerkins of the Islamic police. Some of what the jihadists destroyed was filmed as they reduced it to rubble. This, a key local shrine. They've had months to destroy the place, and they could do worse, destroy Timbuktu's greatest treasure, somewhat unsuccessfully trying to set fire to the purple jerkins of the Islamic police. I visited this precious place in the year 2000. I stood on what is now the desecrated mosque. I wandered freely, absorbing the history of it all. We'll be right back.
fatality.